Well, you know, the family, our family, was really musical. We had ukuleles and piano lessons and singing and aunts and uncles and grandparents. But when we went, we heard about the Beatles, and then they came to America, and we saw them on TV on the Ed Sullivan Show. And it was devastating. It was wonderful. It was like the culture shift. And so we were just possessed to have guitars and possessed to make a band and sing and play and learn all their songs and, you know, and everything else on the radio that we liked. So, you know, we got their albums, we slowed them down to half speed, we learned the parts. It was the beginning of I Feel Fine, I believe, where a guitar string goes ding, you know, that whole part. We were doing club gigs in Canada, cabaret, as they call it there, and we were playing this dive, like a dinner dance place, a dinner club, and disco was coming up, and we were just this rock band that wanted to look rock. They wanted us to dress in uniform, you know, matching outfits, and never chew gum on stage, and never say a swear word on stage. So we felt really rebellious about that because we were really rockers, and we got fired because Anne said something about the food that was so bad there on stage. And the same night we got a call to open for Rod Stewart in Montreal. So we got on the train and went across the country and opened for Rod Stewart in Montreal. And it was, they'd heard our stuff because the album had just sort of come out and we were still playing clubs and all that. And they knew the song, they knew Magic Man, I think it was. And they all put their lighters up. And we were like, oh, this is a moment, you know? That was a hair-raisingly amazing moment that said to us that we do have a snowball's chance in hell. We'd been opening for a band called Nazareth in Europe and also for Queen, actually. And Nazareth had a hit with a Joni Mitchell song that they covered called This Flight Tonight that had that kind of that riff. And so we kind of borrowed that and we made it into Barracuda. And then we saw the guys from Nazareth later and they were pissed. They were, you took our riff. But it's, you know, that's what everybody kind of, in, you know, you borrow from what you love and then you make it your own. But it's one of those sounds too. It's one of the tone, guitar tones that I'm still trying to figure out what we did because it's hard to recreate.